Wayne and Claudia Brood are caretakers on a private island on the Upper Peninsula in Michigan. Most of the year, they cross a quarter-mile channel by boat to the mainland. But during the winter freeze, they exchange the boat for a snowmobile and an ice bridge.
I get nervous at times, especially at the beginning of the year when it's just freezing up, because there's spots that don't freeze up as well as other spots.
We've been crossing by snowmobile for a couple of days already.
Same place we've crossed for many, many years. We really thought that the ice was fine. And as he started across, we hit a slushy spot in the ice. And
I throttled up on a snow machine, but it just spun and it kept going down.
It just sunk into the ice. The ice just kind of collapsed around us.
And the snow machine drops away from you and you're in the water floating.
I just knew that we were in trouble, and I just immediately started praying to God that, because I didn't know how we were going to get out of this situation. But I wasn't afraid of dying, but I was afraid of watching Wayne die, because he wouldn't have left me there. He would have done what he could to get me out.
As they struggled in the freezing waters, Wayne's brother-in-law, Bert, who was visiting for the weekend, heard a noise that caught his attention.
I just heard the snowmobile when he revved it up, and it spun out before it went down, I guess, and then that's what I heard. And it just sounded a little unusual, so that's why I looked that way.
God really intervened, and there's no doubt about it, because had he not, I don't think Bert would have heard us or seen us. The location he was at was quite distant.
I ran up in that boat shelter, and the first thing I saw in the door was a canoe sitting there. So I grabbed this old canoe and shoved it out there, and then went behind it and used it as a platform to get on the weak ice.
And he was pushing it out to Claudia, and the ice is cracking as he's going.
The end of the canoe came out and ran over the hole, and he's like, grab a hold of the canoe and I'll pull you out. Well, I put my arms up to grab it, but my hand, by that time my fingers weren't bending anymore. I just said, Bert, I can't do this.
Got a hold of her one hand and started pulling, trying to get her back on the ice. And by that time I seen Wayne, he was starting to crawl out himself. He was able to finally get up after he knew that I had a hold of Claudia, that he got out on the ice himself. And he tried to come help me too, get Claudia out, but the ice started to give way.
None of us later on could remember how I got in the canoe. To this day, I don't know how I got in the canoe. I was so tired.
God was there. Angels were there. Just one little miracle after another. God could have taken us home that day, but he chose not to.
Moments later, they were back at the house. They had survived.
I stepped in into the shower, and Wayne put his arms around me. I just started sobbing, and I was just praising God that I was alive.
When you've been together so many years and realize how close you've come to being separated,
Wayne and Claudia continue to cross the ice bridge, always aware of how fragile life can be, and thankful that they've been given more time.
I know that I am here because God ordained it to be so. I'm not here because Bert saved me. I'm here because God wants me to be here. After it happened, it really gave me freedom. I was able to share my faith and how that I knew where I was going to spend eternity.
Thinking back to that day, glad I'm here. Praise God.
God saved us twice in our lifetime. Once when Wayne and I trusted Jesus to be our Savior, and then again when he orchestrated our rescue that day out in the channel. From now until the day I die, I will spend the rest of my life praising him and trying to live for him, and to make good of the extra time that he has given me, because I know that that's why I'm here. If one thing it taught me, it was life is very fragile. you may not have tomorrow. And my question to people would be, are you ready? Are you ready to meet Jesus? Are you ready to stand before the God of all the universe? Because it can happen so fast.